Hello friends, my name is Asun Das, and today we are going to look into a fresh flow generator. Actually, the video ship is not very clear, so I thought first I'll explain a little bit theory. So while looking on the video, it's clear for y'all, and you can understand it better. The fresh flow generator is a machinery which produces fresh water by using seawater, and for heating purpose we use jacket water, and most of the ships is having vacuum type system. So starting, what do we have is one seawater pump, or we call it an ejector pump. Which supplies water to condenser. Now this is your condenser. Condenser in the sense a heat exchanger which will condense your evaporated steam into water. And then the outlet, it enters and it comes out. Now why I've taken a green is most of the time seawater is having green color coding in on ship. Then we, from the outlet, most of the time there's a tapping which goes as a feed for the evaporator. Then what happens is, now the line which I'm drawing is basically a line from a ship, and it is not necessary that always the same line will be there. Lines will be different, always different, and but the idea and working principle is same. So if you understand one, then you will understand all. From here, one tapping is given to feed. Now this is very less water is flowing. The diameter of this pipe is big, but this one is very small. But while drawing line diagram, might not feel the difference. And then on the ship which we had gone, then there were ejectors. Two ejectors actually were there. Normally we have only one ejector, and here there were two ejectors. Again, design depends on the design, and what was happening is one ejector was for creating vacuum. I hope you can see this clearly. Now if you see, here I have shown two side glasses. Condenser part will be in this way, then there will be a tray where the water gets collected, and this can be seen, the condensed water gets collected here, you can see in this side glass. Another side glass which will show us the evaporation taking place, or even a slight brine we can see. So this is the second side glass. Feed is given from down. This is the evaporator, and yes, for one I've drawn the blind the for which brings the vacuum will go to this ejector. Then the other one, let's take it as a red color, will be around this level where its primary purpose is to suck the brine. What is brine basically? Now what is brine basically is whatever evaporation takes place, whatever salt water remains, that is basically a brine, and whatever dirt and other things, that is also a brine. So here the other ejector is basically sucking a brine. Then what happens, this goes overboard. Understood. So this is the part where your, let's see what a cytic says. And sometimes what is there, there is also a chemical dosing line here, this part. But on this ship we'll see it somewhere here. Understand? On the side, right? This will be from a chemical dosing tank or small chemical dosing unit. And then evaporator. Evaporator will have jacket in, jacket out, and also bypass valve. Now, sorry, this valve will be here. Okay. Now this is very important, the bypass valve. This helps you to control the temperature. While starting, you will start the ejector pump. This is taking suction from sea chest. Then ejector pump will start, you will run. Pressure will build up, feeding will take place, ejector will suck air. Vacuum will start building up, vacuum gauge will be somewhere around here, and slowly slowly when the vacuum comes down, then you know that you have to start the heating. Heating you start slowly, you bring the temperature up around and around 40 to 44 to around 250. Try to maintain around 44 to 50. Once you start exceeding above 52, if it goes above 52, then you have to adjust your heating by opening this valve. Now this valve in normal running condition basically depends ship to ship. It's half open, half open or half shut, you can say. And it depends, if your heating is not enough, you have to close. Depends on the production. If it goes above 52, then your production starts dropping down. Production, not exactly production starts dropping down. Basically what happens, your scale formation increases and that results in the production dropping. So now we will see the video on ship. Now looking at the length, I think I should keep a theory video separate and the practical which I am going to show, I'll make a separate video. Again, the things which I have missed out is jacket water enters around 84, around 80 to 84 is the best performance entry. And it will be around 10 degrees or 12 degrees less, so around 70 will be outlet. And depending on the temperature of the shell, water around boils at around 60 degrees, but inside the temperature, actually heating is taking place around 60, 65 or even 70 degrees. Depending on the temperature, this is the best temperature which I'm telling you. But actually water boils around 45 degrees because of the vacuum created. And that we all know the theory. How the pressure drop results in the temperature drop of evaporation. Okay. And the demonstration I'll show in another video. Thank you.